Yes, so the main issue, as we know, is at the back end of the year where TBC results were skyrocketing. They went from 4 TBC to 78, and it was a big issue. So we put in the system. Once we had the system put in, we realised then that it was our water wasn't reaching the high enough temperature.
So originally you thought maybe it was a tank issue or a plant issue compared to the hot
exactly,
water?
Exactly, yes. Yeah. So say what we did to try and solve it was we'd go in with a different type of washer, that kind of a thing, maybe add in an extra chlorine wash a week, but that didn't seem to relieve the issue. Then we put in the system, and then we realised then that our water wasn't reaching high enough temperature, so therefore then the tank wasn't being sterilised.
Perfect. How about the system in general, installation, was there much issue with it? Or
no, installation was very easy, really. I mean, all this is a little probe, so we have a probe on the midline when it's coming in, we have a probe on the bull tank itself, so then it'll be able to then tell you the temperature, and we have a probe on the water coming in. So that then, like I said, is with the water issue then, we were able to see then. And the reason why for the milk line coming in, the probe on the milk line is, so then we then know when milk is introduced, and therefore then if there's an issue where the bull tank then isn't turned on, or something like that, then we then get notified because of that.
Yeah, and that will be linked up to your phone and your laptop, depending
exactly,
on
what
usage needs to be.
Exactly.
And how long installation-wise are you looking at?
Oh, maybe 2 or 3 hours.
2 or 3 hours. So minuscule.
It's very, very small. Very small.
And it wasn't affecting any of your daily jobs?
No. They came in after Minkin and did it, and there wasn't an issue.
So it wasn't affecting. And as far as you're concerned, it was worth its weight.
Yeah.
You know, just go through the alerts then that come through from the system itself and how you find them.
So I suppose the first alert is when the milk comes in. That way then you're able to see then what temperature the milk comes in at for a start, and then what way or how low the temperature the plate cooler cools it down to.
Okay.
Then, like we said, mentioned about the hot water that comes in then down here. And then, obviously, if that hot water isn't reaching a high enough temperature, you also get a notification of that. Then, with the bull tank, then after a collection, if the bull tank isn't turned on, you also get a notification of that if it's not being turned on. And then also then when the milk is collected, if the wash hasn't been turned on, you also get a notification of that. So basically you get an all-around view of if there's one element of your system that's not working, you get notified pretty much within a very, very short period of time.
So you have 3 probes set up at the moment. You have an automatic washer on the plant and an automatic washer on the tank.
Yeah.
So by right you need those 3 probes to make sure everything's doing it right, especially when you're not here, if need be, if you're off to urgent.
Exactly, yeah. So for instance, if you have a relief milker in, things can happen or the bull tank might be turned on.
Exactly. You'll get no vacation with that within 30 minutes.